Such a small cochlea, it's something which is equivalent to the size of a peanut, you know, coding out 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz is a miracle. This miracle happens because of the outer hair cells and the nature of the outer hair cells. You know, the property of the outer hair cells, which helps to have this wide range of response, is known as electromotility. It is said that the body of the outer hair cells and these cilias, they expand and contract depending upon the electrical stimulus or the feedback which they get in. So, electromotility. So, the outer hair cells, these cilias are not embedded in the tectorial membrane, that much we know, as the inner hair cells. So, they are placed out like this. What happens? This is something what might be happening. Now, usually we know that 90% of the supply to the outer hair cell comes through the auditory cortex via efferent nerve fibers, and the input from the inner hair cells, actually 90% goes into the auditory cortex via the afferent fibers. The moment there is a sound and there is a vibration, then at the periphery the outer hair cells, they amplify out the soft sounds based upon the contraction and elongation of their cell bodies as well as the cilias, because of electromotility. And once these are stimulated, the inner hair cells are stimulated, the input goes in, and then immediately there is a feedback. Based upon the feedback, again, to that particular sound, the electromotility responses would be changing, and the body of the outer hair cell and the cilia of the outer hair cell would be responding differentially because of this electromotility of the hair cells, and would be transmitting out information to the inner hair cell, which in turn feed it to the auditory cortex. This is probably the way because of which there is a non-linearity in the cochlea. There is a amplification to certain sounds, and certain sounds would be damped off. That's how the outer hair cells would be contributing to the process of hearing.